Hola clase, ¿qué tal? Buenas tardes, buenos días o buenas noches, dependiendo de a qué hora estén viendo esto. Ah, rápidamente, no quiero que tengamos mucho tiempo en esto, porque ustedes han estudiado, ¿verdad? ¿Han estudiado? Ojalá que sí. Anyhow, today we're gonna just, I'm gonna do it in English, so we have a quick review of what we've learned so far up to this point. Now, I hope the lighting's good. Everything else, you know, it's just, this is weird. Anyway, I mean, estoy en mi garaje, en la cueva. Anyhow, this is what we've done so far. I hope you guys can see the screen. Las cláusulas nominales. It's called nominal clause. If you haven't heard that before, don't worry about it. It's just a crazy name. But you've learned this before, see? So we're gonna use the verbos that we've practiced in the Quizlet, see? For example, él tiene una A, ¿recuerdan? And then I ask you to memorize the counterpart, which is present subjunctive. Presente indicativo, presente subjuntivo. You guys did amazing on the quiz, on the test. You did pasado, and then you did pasado subjuntivo. You did great, so you know the verb forms. Now, what I see is that we need to practice when to use it, see? So watch. It is really important to understand this point, see? Every time we have these expresiones azules, you're stating a fact, you're stating a reality, even though, you know, sometimes it seems like, me parece que, it seems to me, doesn't sound like a reality. It is, if it seems to you, it's real, see? So anyway, all these blue expressions, sé que, me parece que, pienso que, creo que, es evidente, es obvio, está claro. Those are expressions that you're stating a fact, and they all with indicativo, the ones you have on your Quizlet. So, let me give you one quick example. Me parece que tiene una A. Es evidente que viene de la escuela. And you can connect all of those with indicativo. Now, subjuntivo expresses wishful thinking, emotions, impersonal expressions. It's called preferred weddings. That's the acronym that you have on your Google Drive, in your folder. So now, what we have to do is connect these to the subjunctive counterparts, see? So wishful thinking. You've seen this, I say it all the time. Ojalá que tengas una A. Ojalá que tu amiga tenga una A. Ojalá que él venga a la escuela, see? You can also say, ojalá que él viniera. I wish he came or he would come to school, ¿verdad? Ojalá que yo tuviera una A. I wish I had an A, kind of thing. See? Now, what gets a little tricky is because you cannot use the past subjunctive. Quiero que tuvieras. We have to do it. You have to change this into the past. So in any event, check another example. Me alegra que tengas una A. Me alegra, makes me happy, que vengas a la escuela. See? Now, let's take a quick look. El pasado. We need to know pasado. We've talked about past tense countless times. It's difícil, pero no es imposible. So now, check this out. Yo no sabía. I didn't know. Supe. I found out. Me dijeron. They told me. Yo pensaba. I thought. Oí. I heard. Fue evidente. Era evidente. It was evident. It was clear. ¿Verdad? Now, you can put past tense or present tense. See? Yo sabía que él tiene una A. Me dijeron que él tiene una A. Me dijeron que él viene de la escuela. But you can also say, me dijeron que tú tenías o él tenía una A. Me dijeron que él vino o él venía a la escuela. See, so you're using language in a such a fluid way, you know, so if you start making sentences, they sound pretty sophisticated. Another one is, look, this is preferred weddings en el pasado. Now you can say, yo quería que él tuviera una A. I wanted him or her. Yo quería que tú tuvieras. Yo quería que tú vinieras a la escuela. Necesitaba, I needed him, que tuviera una A. Necesitaba que tuviera una A. Yo necesitaba que él viniera a la escuela. Fue una lástima. It was a shame que no tuvieras una A. You didn't have an A. See? And so on and so forth. Todas estas expresiones están en su folder. Now, This is the thing we need to focus on. This is if clauses. Now that you have this, these verbos, tuviera, viniera, quisiera, hiciera, pusiera, fuera, pensara, cantara, these verb forms, we're going to recycle them to create an if clause. If clauses,
hope you guys can see, hope it is not too trim. See, if clauses that are contrary to fact,
hypothetical statements. So you go, si yo tuviera una A, if I had an A, si yo viniera a la escuela, if I came to school, si yo hiciera mi tarea, if I did my homework, si yo fuera tú, you've heard me say that, si yo fuera tú, if I were you, si yo pusiera atención, if I paid attention, si yo cantara bien, if I sung well, I would be, sería famoso, ¿no? Now, for this part, for the if clauses, oops, for the if clauses, you see what I try to do? For the if clauses, we've learned the first part, and I'm going to make another video for it. ¿Está bien? Ojalá que estén bien, y perdón por el desastre, esto no es profesional, pero es bueno.